Hey there. I had some requests to put together something a little bit more unisex, so I made this cardigan, which is something that both boys and girls can wear. Again, I made this without a pattern. I don't know why I have this habit, but I do. The way I make stuff without patterns is I always just take something that I already have, and then I look at it and try to figure out how it's made. There's plenty of different ways to make cardigans, but I happen to have this American Apparel one on hand. When you make something without a pattern, basically you just study the fabric. You look at how the borders are done, what's going on with the shoulders, you look at how they do the cuff. In this case, with cardigans, you also look at how they do the pockets. Each time you try to do this, you basically get better at knowing, oh, what do I sew first, what do I sew second, and then how will it turn out in the end. It's really good practice for your mind, just visualizing these things. Also, it's good because a lot of really cool designer stuff doesn't even have patterns for it, and the only way you can know how to sew it is by thinking it through and visualizing and holding it, looking at the seams. My tips for making a cardigan is three things. One, find a color that you're really happy with. Two, find a weight that you're really happy with. You don't want it to be too thick because then you'll be like sweating, and you don't want it to be too thin because then it won't have that warm plushy look. And number three, make sure you find buttons that you like. I chose these gold brassy buttons that have emblems on them. Choose whatever buttons you like. I chose these ones because this really, really rich green right away made me think of boarding school and Slytherin and all that kind of stuff. So I thought these kind of buttons would be perfect for it. We'll start by cutting out a 2.5 inch section to make the border that goes all around the entire front of the cardigan. Then we need to cut a 4 inch section that's going to make our cuffs and the bottom of the cardigan. Fold the fabric and trace out half of a cardigan on top of the folded edge so that the whole back is symmetrical. Cut through the two layers, and this will be the back of your cardigan. Fold the fabric over again, and this time lay down the front side of the cardigan to trace out two front pieces. Cut out what you've traced and make sure those two pieces aren't joined together since they're totally separate when they're on the front. Fold the fabric over once more and then bring it all the way across to make 4 layers in total. Lay down the sleeve along the edge of the fabric and trace out that shape so that you have 2 sleeves in total. The shoulder is a rounded shape, so make sure that when you're cutting out the sleeves that you start off with the rounded corner. Use whatever scrap you can find, fold it in half, and cut out 2 rectangle shapes to make the pockets. Fold the wide strip in half and iron that down to make the cuffs and the bottom of the cardigan. Iron the narrower strip into thirds by folding one side up, ironing it down, and folding the other one over and ironing that. Fold down about 1 centimeter on both of the pockets and iron that down. Then fold in 0.5 centimeter on the left side and the right side, but not on the bottom, and iron those as well. Sew the front pieces to the back piece, right sides together at the shoulders. Lay it on the ground right sides up, and this is what it should look like. Put the sleeves right side down on top of the shirt and pin it together at the shoulder points. After pinning, the next step is to sew the sleeve to the shirt in the semicircle shape. Sew right sides together from the sleeve to the armpit all the way to the bottom of the shirt on both sides. I recommend starting at the armpit and sewing outwards, and don't sew 90 degrees, but instead pull it straight so it's ready for you to move your arms around. Onto the pockets, use 2 stitches in parallel to hem the edge. Pin the pockets to the bottom of the 2 front pieces, and don't worry about the hole at the bottom because we're going to seal it off eventually. One trick to finish off any open ends really smoothly is to pull on the thread so that the little loop pops in through the other side of the fabric, then slowly ease it out with a sharp object and tie a knot with your fingers instead of using a backward stitch. Cut out the cuff pieces so that they fit around your elbows and your hips. Open up the arm cuffs and sew it right sides together to make a circle. Iron those seams open and then fold it in half so that it's ready to be attached to the sleeve. The way you attach a cuff to a sleeve is you slide the cuff over the sleeve so the right sides are touching, you line up the two seams, and you pin it together, working all the way around until the whole thing is ready to be sewn together. Pin the bottom cuff to the bottom of the cardigan right sides together, and you may need to pull on it to make sure everything fits right. When you're sewing, make sure you use the pins as landmarks to pull on the fabric so that everything works out in the end. To do the border, leave about an inch at the bottom, hide the raw edge on the inside of the cardigan, and then fold over the pretty edge and pin it down. After that, sew from the bottom to the neck and back down. To hide the little 1-inch borders that were left at the end, fold it so that it's on the inside of the cardigan and then zigzag stitch across the whole thing to fix it in place.
Now that the bulk of the cardigan is done, you still have to do the buttonholes and the buttons. There's a whole bunch of different ways to do buttonholes, but the way I did them is I sew a zigzag 2 times, and then I cut down the middle with a pair of scissors. And for the buttons, I do have an instruction video on how to sew on buttons, but it's pretty as per normal, just stab through, go around, loop through the buttonhole. Basically, just make sure that the buttons and the buttonholes line up. Now, you may know that recently I got a serger. I decided to put it to a little bit of test. My mom helped me, and we sergered this edge. This is what a serger edge looks like. I will see you all next week.